are we making today?
We're gonna make crunchy peanut pepper cookies.
Ooh.
Yeah. Crunchy peanut pepper.
That, I kind of made that up, but it's like cayenne pepper and salty peanuts.
Well, show us what to do here, okay, please. So, I'm your sous chef here.
Yeah, I'm gonna put you to work.
I'm just gonna stand here holding the spoon.
That's a really good start. I'm gonna start with the flour,
okay.
Dry ingredients. And to the dry ingredients, I'm just adding kosher salt, and I add a lot of salt. I like to make these cookies like salty, spicy, sweet, all the things together. So that's a lot of salt, baking soda, and a little bit of cayenne pepper. Actually, it's kind of a lot of cayenne pepper.
It does look like a lot of cayenne. It's like a teaspoon?
It's 1¾ teaspoon.
That is a naughty,
that might be too
naughty
much,
quantity. I love it, though.
You can put as much or as little as you feel like.
But it's our spicy show, so let's go above and beyond.
I'm going to do it for real.
Get with it. All right, what would you like me to mix your wets here?
I want you to mix my wet ingredients. So that's just butter, and you're going to do the granulated sugar and the brown sugar. And I like to do this by hand.
No standing mixer or hand mixer,
No, I don't want to wash anything that I don't have to wash.
I
do this by hand. I also think that when you don't beat in a lot of air, your cookies come in a little chewier and a little denser, which is what I like in a cookie. There's an egg, and then I'm using unsweetened peanut butter because I want to control the amount of sugar that's going
in
my cookies.
And this is so much easier to mix. Like, if you get that, fresh ground stuff at the health food store or whatever, it's got such a great consistency for
it's
baking,
delicious.
Too. It just kind of really uniformly goes in there, right?
It has that a nice peanutty flavor, as opposed to just tasting like sugar. So, peanut butter, I'm helping you. Vanilla.
Thank you.
Flavor combo is just spectacular.
Yeah, that's...
Jeff, don't stop.
Yeah, don't
stop. Come on, Jeff, work
those arms. I just wanted one little union break.
But then I'm going to add, these are roasted salted peanuts.
Yum.
Salted.
More salt.
More salt.
Extra.
I know, it's kind of nuts, but...
Are they ground up?
They're very lightly chopped. You could even chop them less than this.
Okay. All right, should we make some, portion out some?
Let's do it. So now we're just scooping. Pretty easy.
We got some sugar here, and are we going to press them down? Are we going to bake them on natural?
I'm going to roll them because I am also a food stylist. And to make them look really cute, if you roll them in nice little circles.
Cute food always tastes better.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I mean, it's absolutely not necessary, but then they come out nice and perfect. All right, now the fun part, the part that's like quintessential peanut butter cookie. We have to, it looks like you don't get to do this part.
That's okay, we only got one fork. It's basic cable, we don't have too many.
Budget cuts.
What do you dip in the fork in?
A little bit of sugar.
Oh,
that's
okay.
It, just so that it doesn't stick. I mean, this is just classic peanut butter cookie situation. 350 degrees for 12 minutes.
All right, let me do the honors.
Okay.
I don't want you to do anything, you're our guest. Oven's hot today. Here we go. And these are them, we're ready to go.
Are the finished cookies.
Oh, they're perfect, of course.
Oh,
let me try this.
I try one, too. They're crunchy. You could bake them a little less and make them chewy, but I'm into crunchy.
You don't need to do anything else with these.
Mm.
It's like the first peanut butter cookie I've eaten where it's like, this is real peanut butter.
Yeah.
This is not like a hint of peanut butter. Samantha, thank you so much for coming here on The Kitchen. Come back anytime, please.